If you use Excel regularly, this video is extremely important for you because we are going to talk about a very important feature which is often ignored, and that's these green marks. These green marks are actually a warning, even though they are green in color. Most of us have learned to just consciously or subconsciously ignore them, or some people go one step further and say, I want to get rid of it. So click on it, click on the warning and say ignore error. Please do not do that. These are really useful. They ensure accuracy and prevent mistakes. These green marks are visible only on the Mac and Windows version, not on the mobile app, not on browser. Now, where are these controlled from? Well, go to File, Options, Formulas. On the Mac, you go to Excel, Preferences, Error Checking. Here you will see Background Error Checking. What does that mean? While you're working, Excel is checking, is there something which can cause problems, show inaccurate things, and then if it does find it, it gives you that green mark. These are different reasons why the green mark comes. Now, why green? Why not red? Oh, because Microsoft has been using red color for comments for a very, very long time. So they could not change the meaning of red. So let's start with one of the commonest and most dangerous error. Here I have two simple formulas. This including all the rows, and this one is including only three rows because I want Jan, Feb, March only. The same data may be used in multiple places. So I have another place where someone has put the formula. It could be me or someone else. Like that, across sheets, there may be multiple formulas which depend on this range. Now, next month, I'm going to update this data. When I add more data, I know I have to go and change the formula, which I'm going to do. The problem is, I may forget to update all the formulas. Now, if someone looks at this formula, they think the total revenue is 40. Actually, it's 90. So I'm going to take a wrong decision and it'll have bad impact on my business. So that's the risk. And Excel is trying to help you mitigate that operational risk by showing you a warning. That green mark is a warning to tell whoever is looking at it, do not trust that number. Click there, click on this exclamation mark and read what is written. Formula, omits, adjacent cells. No, in this case, you do not want to ignore the error. You want to ask Excel to update it. And that's what Excel will do. You don't have to go and find out how many rows were added. Very good. Risk eliminated. Only problem now is this is one of the formulas which was dependent. Now, of course, I can go to trace dependence and then go one by one. There is a better way of looking at all the formulas which need to be updated. So I come back. Now I see this green mark. Because Excel thinks you have missed two items. But for you, this is not a mistake. This is what you want, Jan, Feb, March. So in this case, you do not say update formula. In this case, you say ignore error. So depending on the situation, you decide update or ignore. Now let's look for other formulas which need to be updated. Go to Formulas tab and look for this button, Error Checking. It will find the next item which needs to be repaired. It'll ask you, do you want to update or ignore? You decide and then go to the next one, then go to the next one till you finish all the errors. You have to repeat this on every sheet and only then you are safe. Now, of course, all these errors are going to come back when you add more data. This error did not come because I have consciously said I want to ignore the error. But this one came, others will come. Now, this error checking is a repetitive process. Obviously, you don't want to do that manually. So let Excel do it for you. And that is why there is table. So select the data, insert table. Yes, it has headers. And now notice what happens. I'm not just adding one, but I am adding many rows. It is 258, automatically changed. And if I go to formulas, error checking, there are no errors because now Excel is proactively finding the dependence and updating the formulas automatically. So that's why you should use table and that's how you handle green marks. Another is math error where there is a div by zero. Even there, you will see the green mark. And then how do you handle it? That depends on the math error. Formula omits empty cells. For example, I have four rows and one of them is empty. Now, if I use the average function, so the average is 5. But if I use sum divided by count and I know there are four rows, then I will get a different thing. Now, whether I want to use this or this is my discretion. But because there is an empty cell, Excel is just showing me that there is an empty cell in the range and be cautious about how you are handling it. In this case, the data and the formula are next to each other. In real life, they may not be next to each other. Just to show that, I'm going to copy this formula to some faraway place. Now, because this formula is far away, it helps me find the empty cell. It will give me a red arrow, double click on it, and now I can go and look at it. I can go back and forth with double click, and to get rid of the arrows, I go to formulas and say remove arrows. Another very useful thing is inconsistent formula. Why is it showing an error here? Because this row is multiplied by 3.2, and in this particular row, it is 3.1. So Excel just wants to confirm that this is an exception intentional or it was a typing mistake. If it was a mistake, this is a restore calculated formula, then everything becomes 3.2. The other very common thing is numbers stored as text. Now, of course, we have seen this many times and we convert to number, but many times there are so many such things that you have to do it one by one. And the problem here is if you select all, because the active cell doesn't have an error, that error correction icon is gone. Very smart way of doing it is to click on any cell which contains that error. Press Ctrl A. It may still not select everything. Press Ctrl A again. But now it has selected the whole sheet. And now that icon moved to this because the whole sheet is the context. And now I can say convert to number. And across the sheet, I have changed all text to numbers. That's how you do global correction. Here is another common one. If it finds a date which is 2-digit, it is going to confirm, is it in this century or the previous century? So in this case, I'm going to say this. And in this case, of course, 2056 is very far away. There's another interesting one. We have tables. And in this table, I have put a validation. And it's giving me an error. It's saying this value is a data validation error. How does that happen? It's saying display type information. It's saying in this particular case, the validation is less than or equal to 10. So this is another reason why green marks come. Another important error is when there is a cell which is unlocked and that contains a formula. So when do we unlock a cell? For example, I'm sending this file to someone. I want them to edit the data. So I'm going to protect the whole sheet. But before I do that, I'm going to format cells and I'm going to unlock. Now I protect the rest of the sheet. So the person on the other side can only edit these cells. Now, sometimes by mistake, what happens is I have a formula and that formula cell is also unlocked. That's a problem because the formula itself can be edited by the other party. I don't want that to happen. So it's warning me saying this is unlocked. So you will lock the cell. And the last one we will see is misleading number formats. Very often we refer to one cell somewhere else, just say equal to cell number. And that's what is happening here. This particular cell has currency formatting applied. I'm using that cell somewhere else. It's just a simple equal to reference, paste link. For whatever reason, this has date format applied. Now that's misleading. And that's where it is warning me saying, oh, this is a format problem, misleading format. Let me update the format according to the source cell. One click, it's done. Error checking, which you may have been ignoring, is really not worth ignoring. It's a valuable tool to make sure whatever you do is accurate and it reduces your personal as well as corporate risk. Now, this is the new one which has been introduced recently. In the first column, I have data and in the rest of the columns, I have formulas. Usually, whenever I change data, all formulas are automatically calculated. But in some complex files where this is a performance problem, we disable that feature by going to manual mode. Calculation options, manual. Now, just below manual, you will see format, stale, values. I'm going to click on manual. And now, when I change a number, the formulas are not going to get updated for that row. And then they will be shown with the strikeout. But if this strikeout was not there, I would misinterpret saying, oh, the value is still 1030 and 0.91. Again, leading to a wrong decision. If I press F9 to forcibly calculate, then everything is okay. That formatting will go away. One word of caution. If someone wants to mislead you, they may disable the feature. So if I go to formula options and say disable background error checking, notice this error is gone. And actually this number is wrong, but you may think it is right. And there is no warning. It's a risk. Another way in which people can mislead you is go to a cell which has wrong numbers, but they want you to trust that it is the right number. That person will go to that cell, ignore the error, and now if you go to file options, formulas, you will see that error checking is on and everything is okay. But the problem is you have ignored errors. So that's why there is an option called reset ignored errors, because ignored errors can be dangerous. Now you come back, now you look at the error and update the formula to get the correct results. So in short, what is the best practice? Whenever you get an Excel file from someone else and you want to make sure everything there is accurate, first of all, make sure error checking is enabled. If you are really suspicious, reset. Do an error checking round for every sheet, and then you can trust that Excel file. I'm sure you found this useful. And before you go, I want you to look at two related videos. One is tables, because they are very important. And second, how to enter formulas correctly. Formula best practices. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.